Yeah, I think ultimately that'll be cool off. I think this is definitely pretty tolerant. They're letting me know that I'm bugging the crap out of them. Slow. Stand clear away. Much better, I think. So, hey there, I'm James, and play with the mic. I think ultimately that position is better for them. That'll do it for now. So you really don't want the water to run but a little straight, I mean even though it's down. I just concerned the birds and such. Yeah, it'll be fine if I another bracket there. They pretty soon discover it's your fingers that's doing the work. You need that finger? They still get mad at you. Try to set you up, get between your fingers and such. I like to imagine. But yeah, they will try to get between your gloves and sneak up in there when you're adjusting stuff. Mm-hmm. They get smart. All right, so we'll just give them a little. Really interesting. I have an empty foot. camera. Just trying not to step on the cords. I have an empty Pro Nuke box behind me. Yeah, 100 frames in. I take two boxes away, and I have four to eight extracted frames ready to stick back in here. If I pull both these boxes, but I don't think they're going to be that far along. We'll see.
Honey.
Alright, I'm gonna heave that box all the way around to this box. Free up my hands here. Maybe two cap frames. Say maybe one, maybe two cap frames. We'll see. Space. Here's one I've been working on. Side cap on that one. There we go. I have one. Just nope. Damp on that side, but on the side there, so nope. So, I think what's happened is the dry spell really slowed down the flow. Put those two back together close. Put that back together close. already. Somewhat disappointing, but it looks really good. I was hoping there would have been more. Ready? I'm not doing a good job of staying off the cables. Get those in the ground. Heave ho on the high side this time. Cap. It's okay. Let's see. I'm not even gonna look at those frames. Now we're running to here. Now we run down to a queen check. Just in case she's on the underneath side of the screen. A little puff. You know, it's my first year really having queen excluders on more than one hive. Quick check for sperm cells. Full. Yeah. So that's pretty bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cap cells. So if I find a queen, I'll snag her. And I just have to make a split with that frame. Or even this box. Have a trap over here ready. Yeah, they didn't swarm the other day. They're gonna swarm any moment. Mm-hmm. So now we're on for a queen hunt. There's like six cap queen cells. They look really good. Or yeah, swarm cells. So we're going to see the queen here. Smoker is generating enough smoke at the moment. There's the queen cells. Oh, I thought it was another frame over. I feel like I need to do something special with this. Set it over there against the stump so I don't bugger up those cells anymore. See, I laid that frame over there by the other side of the stump there so I don't bugger the queen cells up anymore. Probably start a swarm. I'm surprised that the queen's landed on me. Oh,
quiet though.
So it's been 12 days, I think. I think that was smart. Here's the thing. I think I wreck all the queen cells, and if there ain't no queen in here in 2 weeks, put one of my other queens in here. Done, done. Got me on the sore finger. The queen, I'm gonna take these two good looking frames, put two lesser frames down in their slot. It'll give them a less feeling of being jammed up. Got plenty of time to fill it before fall. Hoping to big disruption. They have a tour outside the hive. We'll make them feel like they swarm. We're all turned into killer bees. One of them.
not good. I'm gonna beat the snot out of this hive.
They only tripped over the wire once, trampled them a bunch of times. Pulled too many frames because I wanted to get some of the drawn frames down into the brood boxes. So the queen that I did find would have somewhere to lay eggs. So what I did is I cut out all the queen cells, not every single one, I left some cups. I'll go back in here like 4 or 5 days and check those frames. But in the meantime, if they do still swarm, I've got these backup breeders over here with queens. I don't want to expand right now. But if you need a queen cell, contact me in the next 3 hours. If you can even hear me, that's not the purpose of the mic. Have fun watching. I'm gonna walk around a bit and see if I can get them to leave me alone.